Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I created all of these seamless pattern swatches using the new Generate Patterns feature in Adobe Illustrator. I'll be using version 28.6 of Illustrator, which is where we find that beta feature I'm going to be talking about. Now, because it's beta, it is still evolving, and that means it's only going to get better and better. But I think after you watch this video, you'll see there are some things that we can use and use them quite well right now. First, I'm going to show you how to use the feature. And then as we create some of the patterns, I'll show you how to edit them. But in the end, I'm going to show you all of the prompts that I used to create what you see on the screen. So let's move to a blank document and I'll get started. I'll get the rectangle tool and I'm going to drag out a rectangle and then come over to the properties panel in the appearance area and click on the color fill icon. Everything looks pretty much the same except for this new icon up here at the top. And when I click on it, it opens up the Generate Patterns panel. Now, if you've not used AI before, let me explain what prompt means. This is simply where you type in a description of what you want Illustrator to create. Now, if you don't know where to start, you can click on this little light bulb and Illustrator gives you some examples. You can click on one. It shows you the prompt or the instructions that were typed in to get the design we saw. Let's look at another one. Here's some flowers, and all this says is colorful summer flowers. Now, in some AI programs, you can go into great detail to describe what you want. What I found here in Illustrator is that the simpler instructions, the more likely you are to get what you're looking for. And I am going to use more words than this. Let me highlight this and I'll type in our first prompt. 10, I'm going to say how many I want. Simple folk art Christmas trees, comma, random size, comma, random directions. Now, sometimes Illustrator gets all of those instructions. Sometimes it picks up part of them and you just keep playing with these until you get what you want. Once you have the prompt typed in, you click generate and Illustrator begins giving you your first three variations of what the prompt says. And if you want to see more, you can keep the same prompt and just press generate over and over again. And in about 12 to 15 seconds, we have our first three variations. The one on the left is the one that's applied to the object that's on the artboard, and it also is added to my swatches panel. The other two options are not added until I actually click on them. So let's come back over here. We'll click. This applies the design to the object and adds it to the swatches panel as well. And then here is our third option. And each one of these is a design I know I could find a use for. Now let's come back over here to the swatches panel. As we click on the different variations, if we're playing a lot with the prompts, this area is going to fill up very quickly. And in playing with this the other day, I ended up with so many different seamless patterns in my swatches panel that Illustrator actually crashed on me. So you may want to keep an eye on that. To get rid of these, we have the last one selected. I'll hold down the shift key, select the first one, which selects all three of them, and then I'll click on the trash can. And yes, I do want to delete this selection. However, you will still have them in the Generate Patterns panel unless you delete them here as well. But I'm not going to do that. I think I might have a use for these later. Now, with this prompt, I didn't give any specifics on colors. I let Illustrator just use whatever they wanted. But we can come over to the little color palette, press here, and we have more options. This is the color and tone area, and Illustrator has some color presets for us. The default is none, but there's a pull-down menu. You can choose black and white, muted, warm, cool, vibrant, or pastel colors. I'm going to change this to vibrant color. I'm going to leave everything else the same, and we're going to generate again. And in the interest of time, I am going to speed the video up now each time I generate a new prompt. And we see a marked difference with that color preset. Here's one, here's another, and here's yet another. But we can get even more specific. We can limit the number of colors that Illustrator uses. So let's come down here and put 5 in. I can either choose what the 5 colors are, or I can let Illustrator choose for me. If I want to choose, I'll press the plus sign, and let's just pick 5 colors here. And let's do maybe a light green here, and then we'll generate again. Here we have one option. I don't really care for the background color, but we can change that. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Here are the 3 options here. I know I definitely don't care for this one, so I'm going to go ahead and delete that variation. I'm going to leave the rest of these here for now. Now let's look at this other little icon. When I press it, we can have 3 effects that we can also choose. I'm going to just show quickly each one of these. This is geometric, and honestly, I don't always find much difference between these 3, but you'll want to play with them if you're looking for a specific look. That's a neat pattern. I like that one, and this one, and this one here, and we'll come back up here. I'll uncheck geometric and choose flat design, click generate. Here we have what Illustrator's calling the flat design, and then I'll uncheck flat and choose doodle, and we'll generate that. So we have the first one, and the second one, and the third one. I'm going to come back and select this design right here, and let's talk about how we edit the pattern if we like most of what we have, but we want to make a few changes. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'm going to double click on the object that has the pattern in it I want to edit. That moves me into the isolation mode. Once I'm there, I can go up to object, down to pattern, over and down to edit pattern. You can see this little highlighted area here in the center. This is a repeating part of the pattern, so if I make changes in this area, it'll make changes to the entire seamless pattern. Now, the thing I want to do is remove this background. So I'll get the zoom tool, keyboard shortcut Z, and just zoom in a little bit. Then get the magic wand tool, that's keyboard shortcut Y, and click anywhere on the solid yellow, being careful not to touch anything else. Then I'm going to press the delete key, and that gets rid of the background. It's that simple. You can also select any of these objects in the pattern and change the color on those as well. Now let's close out the pattern options. I want Illustrator to save a copy. I'm going to name this ABC Trees and say OK. Then I'll move out of the isolation mode. I'm going to recenter the artboard, Command 0, and now we have a pattern with a transparent background. Let me show you what you can do with that. Let's get the selection tool, select the rectangle, and I'll give it a black fill, and then I'll copy the rectangle, Command C, and paste it in place, Shift Command V. With the copy selected, I'll come back over and click on our ABC Trees pattern, and you can see how striking that looks with a dark background. So that's how you create a transparent background, which you can use to put in whatever background color you want. Now, what if you wanted the pattern to be a little larger? We can change that as well. I have the pattern selected. I'll go up to Object, Transform, down to Scale. Now notice how small this got all of a sudden. I don't want to change the size of the rectangle, so I'll uncheck Transform Objects. All I want to do is transform the patterns. Then I'm able to just scroll down or scroll up to change the size of my pattern. Now it's not going to affect the swatch itself. If I come back, let's say okay here, and click back on the pattern, I'm back to my original size. And let me just give you a few more examples of some of the prompts that I've used. I'll come back over to the properties panel. We'll click on the color fill icon. This time I'm going to type in forest trees, just a very small change. Let's uncheck everything here. And I don't want to specify colors, so I'll select these and just put no color, and that's how you delete these. I do still want to limit the number of colors to 5, but I'm going to change this to warm tones, and let's generate this. So here's some trees in the forest. Here's another option and a third option. I really like the first one and the third one a lot. Let's change this to Scandinavian cottages. See how cool these designs really are. And you can again come in and edit those. You can change the colors, do whatever it is that you want. Now I'm going to change cottages to flowers and leaves. And I'll change the warm tone to vibrant again and generate. Here's one option, another option, and a third option here. And if I removed the white background, this one would look really sharp with a dark background. I'm going to show you one more. I'll leave the prompt the same, but I'm going to change this to black and white. And we'll move this down to 2 colors and use simply the white and the black, and then I want this to be doodle, and we'll generate. Here we have 3 different variations of our black and white prompt, and I really like this first one. The first thing I would do is go in and give it a transparent background, remove the white, and then I could place this over any color that I wanted to, and I'd have a really nice seamless pattern. And you're probably going to create some patterns that you're going to want to use in other projects, and you're going to have to save those to your library because you're going to lose them once you close out of the document that you're working on. I'll leave a link at the end of this video to a tutorial that shows you exactly how to do that, and I recommend that if you want to keep these patterns, you check that video out next. It's actually a tutorial about adding new color to the swatches panel, but the color swatches and the pattern swatches work in exactly the same way, so you'll be able to learn how to save those pattern swatches by watching this video. You can watch the whole thing, or you can jump to about the 5-minute marker, which deals with the saving part. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope that you've got all sorts of ideas you can't wait to try in creating these wonderful patterns with Illustrator's new Generate Patterns feature. I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.